Rome's a musical collaboration between Danger Mouse, Daniel Loopy, Jack White, and Nora Jones. We were inspired to make an interactive experience for one of the songs called Black, and it's called Three Dreams of Black.
Chris and I worked together to build this WebGL film where users are able to steer themselves through the entire narrative.
In this project, there's three separate dreams, and it's kind of moving through several different storytelling techniques. And what you have are some 2D graphics, you've got video, you've got 3D graphics, and it's all kind of playing together through WebGL. We wanted to think about an experience that was specifically meant for the web.
Making a music video for the web browser is totally different than making a music video on film, of course. Three Dreams of Black is created with code, so most of what you see during the experience is not video, but it's real-time rendering of visual models.
Experiencing and interacting with a truly immersive 3D world is now as simple as firing up a modern browser with WebGL, like Google Chrome. WebGL essentially transforms your browser into an open source video game console. You can use your mouse to change your angle of vision, move and create objects, and a whole lot more. This is very exciting.
The WebGL is just an extension of JavaScript. It runs, you know, in the browser without any plugin whatsoever, and it really lets us create a 3D interactive experiences just using HTML and JavaScript. So WebGL is hardware accelerated, meaning that it uses your video card to render all those graphics really, really fast, which wasn't possible before.
So when we were putting Rome together, we stumbled upon some really interesting things. And a lot of those demos are shown on this website, so you can start to see some of the experiments and things that WebGL is capable of. And WebGL is somewhat like JavaScript, where you can just view the source if you're interested in it. And we've also released some of the source with documentation so that you can start to learn how to use WebGL in different ways. I think WebGL represents another step in pushing the web forward. The types of content that you can expect to see on the web looks a lot different than what you've seen in the past. It's not just text and images, but now there's dynamic real-time graphics, there's audio, multimedia, video, and it's all being fused together in one space.
I think WebGL and web technologies like HTML5 will go a long way towards enabling developers to make experiences like Rome happen, and we can't wait to see what they can do with that.